It's 10:14 p.m. on the 5th day, 8th month, 2023. Here we're looking here is so the current imagery of the United States of America is some very bad man-made storms that have been blown up. And I'm going to go over them a bit with you and how they've been moving through certain corridors of electromagnetic frequency created by the... You have to excuse the screaming in the background. This is my rude downstairs people getting drunk and deciding that they should be as loud as they want. So please excuse that interruption. I did tell them I was going live, and it got louder. Okay, so this is the respect I get. So I'm going to go in here now and have a look at some of these, but it might be best if I go over to a bit of what to be expected. And I have a big concern for the Chicago area here coming in on Monday. As they're going to begin, this low is going to turn as it hits these winds on the lake here. And this low coming over is going to compact. It's going to compact just south of Chicago. And, well, the west side, it might be having some problems. Because, well, the land grabs are going on. And as the storm comes over, it's going to cause some problems. Not just the accumulation, but the winds and stuff. And the possibilities of tornadic activity when this thing comes through. It is very passable, and I call all this the Chicago area. Because if they ever super city this, all this, they'll do it all the way from Gary, Indiana over when states' rights totally evaporate into the federal military industrial corporate complex. Yeah, it'll be a bit too late for you guys in America because you sat on your hands too long. Now look at some of the totals on the 10s coming through here in lower New York. New York City even is showing some extremely high totals as they're going to move a low over the top of New England and up in through Canada. Now you guys get some wicked weather coming. And so you got the big heads up just now. And I'm going to do my best now to show you some of the situation that's going on right this moment. Because there's some very, very, very bad cells coming across the United States in a few pockets. Okay, so I'm going to run this now, and you see this electrical line here, and this is coming around here is going to be your deepest concern. You know, this is through today, through Sunday, and as this comes across the Great Plains of the Midwest, mixing with the cold airs, with the fire smoke and all that from Canada and all the catalysts that are inside of that, there's going to be some big problems. Okay, some really big problems. I'm going to let that roll a minute so you can kind of get an idea. It's going to be extremely electrical, and there's going to be about three or four super cells. We're really, really going to be messing some stuff up. And it's not going to be a very cool time. Okay, so let me turn the volume on my phone down so I can see your comments in case you guys have any questions. So I'm going to go over a bit of what's going on today. As you can see, Tennessee and Kentucky. And as the mountains of North Carolina and the Appalachians compress to chem and it releases out the other side, the Piedmont of North Carolina gets a bit of action. Georgia around the state line and down and through here is going to have some action. And the line coming through New England is going to be deadly. Even seeing tornadic activity through parts of Connecticut won't surprise me. And these are very low areas along the highway corridor here that leads into the tri-state area of New York, New Jersey in here, and there's lots of key travel areas here that are going to be disrupted on Tuesday. Big time. So be very careful. Look at this cell over Yonkers in this picture, Stamford, Connecticut, Bridgeport, New Haven. And there's big highway interchange here in New Haven. There's a big one over here as well that takes you up that direction as you take the rides up into New England and the Green Mountains of Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, and Massachusetts. That's mess in that. So we got quite a situation developing. There's going to be some heavy action around Quebec, and your totals ain't very pleasant to have to look at on the threes, I believe, is when you're going to get some of your first action, as this river here will be absolutely inundated, swelling the streams, killing the dreams. Yeah, they got the moves down pat. They're moving the cold air down with some of them beams I was showing you earlier today. And so right now I can show you, want to show you... I've done a forecastation for a few days and kind of shows you this line. Yes, we are rolling. So I'll go back to the moving line. And then I'll go over rising in. But right now, it's whoever's in the most danger gets my time the most. And tonight is mostly going to be for America, Canada. See how that tracked right on out into the bay up here? When it hits that water there, some of it will smooth out, allows it to fold more, because you'll get a different kind of convections off of the water. And this thing is going to be quite organized. If I showed you the pressures on this when it came over, it was a Lando cane, right? It came over even over the top of Utica. Outside Chicago, it's quite compact. That's why I'm very concerned, and I put their name on the title, right, as it worked its way across the United States and up into Canada. It's taken the smoke with it and dropped a lot of it on the forest up here when it rained out. And so that's not going to be very good for the leaves. I did some checking on the acid pH levels of the rain over me today. Twice today I came in the 6.2 to 6.1 range, which is acidic. So we're seeing acid rain falling out. And if they had all these things that had kept all the pollution down from the Clean Air Act of the 1970s, I shouldn't be picking up acid like this. But when it's proposed in the Paris Accord Governance Agreement document to do sulfuric acid direct spraying or the precursors of it that help it form in the atmosphere. You see those double lows come across? You're in a soggy season here upper Canada. It's so expected. And about the end of the tens, you got another one forming over here near Green Bay, Wisconsin. The Green Bay Packers. The Green Cam Bombers. So let's have a look now. What kind of conditions lead me to say that this is man-made? The first thing I'm going to do is go right to the Mosaic NexRad. Right, and I'll pull up the corridor here where you're going to really kind of, if I pull it back to the continental sectors here, you'll get a better view of the radars. And it's not high enough for me. Let's include Canada in here. All right, now we're going to have a really good look at what the NexRads do. So I've loaded up 200 frames. We're going to see it all, and I'm going to be able to do that. I'm going to go with that NexRad that's there that's loading right now. So you'll see the NexRad flashes and where they're not. Where is the easiest flow corridor, the path of least resistance in the atmosphere? It's through these blanked out areas where the beams are not occurring. You can see the action here going across that's actually directing this storm towards the Chicago area down through here. And with this action here, that the blending of these two is what I'm worried about for the next couple of days. So I'm going to be watching how they work this storm through this corridor here. And if this stays on, it has to start to curve. Won't it? And these little tickles you see coming down are like adjusters. Now, they've crisscrossed all through here in Wisconsin. That storm can't go that way. This storm has to track right through here. This one, because these radars are in, has to track through a corridor here. And this is a very good example of the manipulation. So I'm going to take this down to the sub-regional and let you get a good look at how are they manipulating this storm. How are they moving this through? So let's have a look at this one here, and I'm going to not quite do 200 frames. I'm going to do 96, okay, so it'll go a little faster. Now you'll see the flash is already down here in this direction, right? Time stamps is right here, okay? Right down here in the bottom. Anybody is questioning that. You'll see lots of flashes coming from these other stations. You see pulses manipulating that, creating these barriers. And that one comes on, that's now pinned, right? But it was not flashed on hard until that went past. Boom, create a corridor, pulse, pulse, pulse. Get this moving. Energize that and it evaporated it, right? Dissipated the moisture. And keep this flowing. Bzzzt. Compact that, pulsate it. Let's hit a corridor of evaporation. See? Then it takes new bombs to do that. And if we want to see the new bombs, we're just going to switch. We'll go over to the infrared shortwave. And we can watch the bombs then. Have they deployed chemical catalysts in our skies? And that's the next thing I do do my determinants. What's different from what? And so the slider should be enabled on this. So I'll go back a little bit here. You've seen square edges to things. The rectangular look. The not rotating supercell. Right? That looks a nice round with the square dead in the center. Like bomb, bomb, bomb. Blowed out holes in the top. See them? Exploding right here near the state line, where this is Tennessee. This is the Mississippi River. This border is why it's all squiggled like that. Right? This is Kentucky. It's North Carolina. That's Alabama. Mississippi, of course. Touches Mississippi. Now look at the bombs being deployed over here over the bluegrass state of Kentucky. The Derby is in. Yeah, this is all being generated by bombs. If I zoom back, you'll notice a move. Flat edge and a spray out. The shockwave of the bombs moving things along, and the tickles of the microwaves causing the perturbation. The microwaves are the weather manipulation. The chem bombs are the geoengineering. The planes do cloud seedings to pre-existing clouds. or to go up there to launch a flare into that with a piloted plane would be your seeding programs. But it also could be done remotely to existing cloud masses. So there's different definitions. Did you see that boil occur here? Right on this site here, again, on this Kentucky border. If I roll this down and just do the cursor bit here. Zink, zink. They drew a big bell end right there. Those are Kanban deployments. Microwave bursts, straight lines coming down. See the beam sweat? Keep it straight, keep it compact, keep that chem pressing toward that chem. Keep them droplets big, keep deploying something in the center to keep a lull so a circulation will occur. This hemisphere low is going to go like that, hot's going to go like that. Look at the spray here. That's going to go off screen here in a few. That's a whole field of bombs going off. Right here in the USA. You ain't invited to this fireworks show. You can't even look up to see it because the skies are so hazed. Now look at these bombs here. One state, two state, three states. Covered three states. Nearly four states with one chem bomb. At what point has one state not attacked the other with states' rights? So where's the agreement that allows this to occur? Where's the treaty? Bomb, 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 and bomb, 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 bomb. See? See the chem bombs here? And on this one here, we're doing five-minute jumps. So this thing didn't dissipate in 5 minutes. It's not a condensation trail that of a natural nature. Right? It's chem. And this blew up all at once. And it might not be a factory doing it. Right? Let's look. It comes from an existing chem bomb line. We'll go back here about 15 minutes. But dot, 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 dot. These are bombs going off. This is geoengineering. This is a traveler. See them moving in weird directions? How many flows of the wind did you just have? That one went that way. That one was up and then went that way. There's all your time stamps right there. See it? See the curves? See the chem bomb deployment here at the state line? That's moving the wrong direction. It's wrong way Charlie there. Boom, 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 go to plumes. Well, they collected the blooms. Isn't this that corridor they wanted? They're toxifying it? Well, as we go into like Ohio and there where the train wreck was, that's a little bit more up to the north than the east. Look at this chem deployment here. These are chem bombs fueling up that storm. Oh, say, do you see Dave chem bombed your skies right before your eyes? Booming here, pluming there, pluming here, pluming there. And it's not healthy for the forest to block the sunlight from the trees. So let's go to another sub-regional section here and have a bit of a look around the Chicago area because they have another deployment that was going on up here. Look at this wedge line of stuff here. Okay, so let this load 96 frames. 96 frames. Now we got all sorts of data, and I'll go over here. Have the next red done anything? You absolutely know it. We'll load the next reds now and let you see all the super flashes for this one. Boy, is this one, I'm going to go back 200 frames because I was seeing something a bit earlier that you might find of interest. Yeah, man, it's loading. It's loading the line. Oh, no, it ain't not until I hit the play button. Look at all the scatter barks going out here. Would you look at the gulp? You can't hide your frying up our skies as it hit that corridor of Cam near, flatted right out. Look at that line here going backwards straight. See that? Geoengineering is very, very real. They're very good at working these pressure outflows where the corridor came right through here. Right? Blast it, blast it, blast it, blast it. Aim it, hit it, hit it, pulse it. Keep the squares going. Bzzz, bzzz the backside. Bzzz, bzzz, square that. Over here, over there, coming here, coming there. They have absolutely fried your skies. Absolutely fried them. Here, we'll give you some singletons on that. You want me to sub-regional that? But you got to see the big picture of how they're moving them. Where they put the bumpers down so the ball has to go to a predictable place eventually. Hey, you can have a board full of nails and you can make things go to the park. And look at the pulsation wave here. Look at that. See that right there? And that came from all the way over here, all the way across Lake Michigan, past Kalamazoo even, into the state of Michigan. You're fraying over there. Detroit's about over here. This Lake St. Clair. Look at the pulse. Bzz, bzz, bzz. Getting fried, getting fried. That's Illinois style. That's coming from Illinois. Kirby Indianapolis Airport. It don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime, my ass. They'll fry you from there. Look at the pulse wave coming out in the front very suddenly here. These poor people in Michigan, man, they're getting absolutely killed with microwaves. Look at that pulse here coming in over this way. Pin that storm. Maybe it isn't a corridor slide here over Lake Erie. So far, that's where the corridor has been set. And here's from the beginning, all the pulsations that set it up. Look at all this. It's an absolute crime scene going on here. This one airport here is the absolute blaster. How many straight lines pointing at it? Guilty. Guilty. Exceedingly guilty. I have to screenshot that one with the timestamp of the 5th of August at 5:25. What a shame. Frying your asses to make sure that storm didn't go where it could have. Make sure it has to go to you. And it does a curveball through. And it's going to meet up with ones here going into Kentucky. And that's going to absolutely raise hell tomorrow. And these are very dangerous supercells here. These are going to go tornadic. There's not a doubt in my mind. And they have absolutely kembaminized you. But let's go right in on them. Let's see if we can get the localized. Here you go. They're the ones. So we go back there at 200 and let's let them run here a minute. And let's bust those. They got so many beams going on. It's like watching a Star Wars battle scene and all the stormtroopers are missing. They're just shooting randomly. Hurry, we get the fragments coming now. Mesoscale, here we go. Boom, right over the radar station. This is the main radar station here. So we can see there's other NEXRAD stations are involved in the manipulation of this storm. Many, many more. Here's a pulse line in the front. How do they keep the front square? Explosions in microwaves. And that wasn't that station doing it. This station's frying that way. It's going to get some action here in a minute as it gets a little closer. Yeah, you got to aim it. Get ahead of the corridor. Keep that thing away from the Great Lakes because they already put their beams out there, remember? So we got to watch what they're doing over here in Ohio. Ohio's blasted here and here. They've kicked on one over here in over in Canada. Canada's easy to see. I'll turn on a different one to show you here. Look at the pulse go under this. Bzzz, the fright, Eddie. Your weather is so owned, USA. They're killing you with these storms. They could make them dissipate, but they're making them stronger. You don't think they're not pulsating that storm right there? It's a direct hit on that one cell. It vaporized it. So they defended that town, but not that one. I wonder who lived there. There's another fryer. That's a different kind of pulse beam. It ain't just a freaking spark gap. Well, maybe you have to make a spark gap with another station to fire your EMP pulse when you disconnect that spark. Hall effect type things going on. Oh, you better understand. They'll tell you a half-truth. And if you don't understand the science, to talk the rest of it to them and make them go, and could we go to commercial is kind of a situation is what you get. Look at that big fright Eddie coming on there. Frying you. Frying you, frying you. Canada ain't no better. Yeah. They're a deadly storm in the United States today. And it's all being done with man-made means. All the way down here, they fry the hell out of them too. Look at the next reds here. Watch this. Do I have 200 frame them? Yeah. Takes a minute to load. Give me a second to sip my drink. Electromagnetic frequency from localized next reds are used to manipulate the weather. It's a fact. It's not always harp. We can do a lot with these dipole and quadpole antennas in the next rail. Look at this pulse wave coming out here. It's a wind farm. That's using wind farms. That's usually what that is. It's not a gravity wave. It's not always a harp blast. Billy Hayes taught me about that. What did we have a roaring argument to? And we both were right. Look at that stretch out on that line there, and then the NEXRAD kicks out and gets the circulation going. Pulse waves coming out, using the winds on the big, huge lines of wind farms as fans. You can't tell me it's always turning because the wind is blowing. Come on. Yeah, look at you and laugh. Yeah, man, look at that thing go growing out. So we look and see if that was Kim that did that. Let's have a look. How did this line of stuff grow? This big straight line of crap right there. What is going on? Let's have a look at this. Bomb, 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 bomb. Do you hear? I see it already. So it came in. Right. This thing shed something out right here. This main mass of cloud was non-existent. All right. Everything was flowing in this direction. All right. But suddenly, microwave kicks on here. Chemical catalyst, read that right there. And some of its reactivity with the microwaves in the atmosphere from the beams have nucleated condensates and vibrated them in such a way, stripped its ions, or whatever, caused the plasmas to form. And that vehicle is still deploying. There's another bomb going off from an over there. Let's go in a little bit closer. Let's go a little bit closer. Let me make sure I get my correct one. Was it right over here, wasn't it? I'm sorry about that, but I want this done right. Right, a little bit more to the west. So let's go to the locals. Right, that's that one. Or shortwave. Let's go a little bit closer, right on the state line. It's right about there. Should get a little bit better view. Right. A little bit better view of these bombs. Because they did, they absolutely bombed the hell out of you. I already had this loaded. Yeah, man. Where's these bombs? All at once. Look at the squiggles. See, bomb, 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 bomb there. And it went. Everything should be flowing that direction. So all this is wrong. It's not just microwaves. Chemical catalysts are being deployed in the skies over the United States of America, right here, in where I'm pointing it right now. This isn't. And even look at that one here going the wrong way. Excuse me a minute here. That went the wrong way. Everything's going that way. This is deploying like it's a drone. That's wrong. All these are all going the wrong direction. Changing of flows. How many directions of the wind did you have here? Look at the square to this. From the ground, it might look like round because you're down here. But from above, I see the square look to these. I see they're going the wrong direction. I see the swastika in your sky. While the microwaves do their blastings. Absolutely blasting these. I'm going to take it down to 96. So you watch them push the storm along after it comes through. See the way they're scanning it along, pushing in that direction? Like a wiper blade from the north. I'm telling you, man, we're being cooked, we're being fried, we're being sprayed like bugs, fried like them in the biggest zapper called planet Earth. And there's this sustained beam shooting down here, pulsations over here. This deadly day of storms over the United States of America today is fueled by man-made means. Studied and funded by the Gates Foundation's people that they fund. Now, if we could take this down to now the weather radar, and let's have a look and see if we can catch some of the Canadian fryings. You can see it down here from Montreal. Because theirs will show up on this feed. I had to go to the other ones. Look. See them? See the heaters on? Atmospheric heaters? Watch, this is from 1 hour. It's only 1 hour's worth of feed. Beam shooting out here over Calgary, shooting down that direction. Making sure flows happen in the United States towards a certain way. That's going to encourage the storm to come up and over this direction, kind of like this. This one's going to go, no, she's coming in like this. She's going to curveball like this, and then she'll hit Montreal and all that. Because they're pinning it down. So we'll be watching it. And Chicago's got hell to pay here in a few days. They didn't have the best day over here in Gary, Indiana, and South Bend and all that. Look at the lightning in this line here at cells that I was showing you how they fueled them with Nexrat earlier. They're having a deadly day. Lafayette, Indiana over here is going to be a battleground. Geoengineers' dream is to destroy the world, I think, rather than mitigate floods and stop droughts as you would think it would be used for. Instead, It's Attica. Attica. Right here on a highway. You want to go into agendas? What do you... They got a new bridge proposed for over here. They want it somewhere else. Somebody built a store or a Tesco's over there, so they want a new exit. Yeah, I see a logistical reason for that place. Hey, what about here in Lafayette? I know that's a logistical reason. What do they want here? Do you want some new freedom? Look, all they got to do is swallow these streams here and kill all the dreams down here. Typical geoengineering move, and a tornado can curve up a neighborhood on command. Because it's an electrical phenomenon. So it can be induced by things that induce electrical phenomena. You catching my point? Next reds induce electrical phenomena. Like the stripping of ions, creating of flows. Tornadic activity laid down a very, very big downflows of wind. Now here's this other one I was covering. It was crossing the state line over here. Just went across the Mississippi River through Memphis, Tennessee now. And they're going to get another batch sliding just south there. It'll probably smack Hernando. Hey, Hernando can be bambo. Hey, what a fucking shame. You poor folks. Horseshoe Lake. Capping it. See the creeper? Just starting to get all lightened up. The chem bombs will do the deciding on that one. Yeah, I'm zipping around. It's a very dangerous cell, this one. Look at all the chem. You see it yet, USA? So that's kind of what you got going on there, USA. And I'm going to zip over here to one of my favorite parts of the world. The Down Underwear. Down Underwear. What are you doing under there? Underwear. Under there. What are you eating under there? Okay. Yeah, you just saw the tens. So let's go and give you guide today. So here you guys get it down under. And so however many minutes into the video it is, put the mark down. It's your turn. And so we'll turn the card off, and we're not turning the boom, 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 all the blues ones. I'm just going to give you a basic, because that thing takes 2 hours to load that I usually do. And well, I gave that 2 hours to my country, America. And should I come over here and talk to you folks again? Well, I applied for a visa this morning. So we wait now. Yeah, that big line of storms is coming over your way. It's going to get electrical there, New Zealand and coastal Australia here over the next 24 hours. 36 hours for New Zealand, really. And you'll have a quick batch going through. It's going to get windy, going to get cold, going to be winter time. And about that time here on Tuesday the 8th, later in the evening, a smackaroo for Western Australia, Perth, Mandurah. Bunberry. Berries on your buns. You should watch where you sit down and you won't get bunberries. And if you're eating hamburgers, watch where you sit down because you might get some Asperger's. Dun 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 dun. Hey, we went there. Here we go, as we cruising along the week here, as we head in toward Thursday afternoon, early Thursday, you're going to see some action here coming across Melbourne, and as they release the flow across Cook Strait, some of the totals are going to start to accumulate along that coastline up there. And so watch out for some quick localized bucketing of stuff in low-lying places on your bridges where the traditional low-lying floodings might happen, because you might have a little bit of quick action there. Your infrastructure is in such good shape from all the money they saved during COVID that they went on holidays with. Oh, it's so stressful not having to govern. I have to go to Hawaii now. Was that guy's name Horison? Well, as we head in toward the 13th here, not too good for the old New Plymouth. And this flow here is showing a bit of a doldrum. Means you're going to have a flow switch. Bit of ice snow here over here to the south there. The caca. How you doing, Smelson? Here you go. Have a smackaroo. Looks like they're going to put the beams on to hold off most of what should be coming over here. Why? Because they want to move it over the top. Yeah, you became the bottom boys this time, and it's going up over the top. Pukaki Purdy for Auckland. And the penis insula splits the flow. See it? Which will cause another low to form, gather the shit from down here, sling it back up and over the top in New Zealand one more time. It's expect these totals that you're about to see to rise over about the next 2 days. You're really going to see what you're about to get. And it looks like you guys are about to get another 10. Eh, maybe about 8. 8 there. Easily you're going to see 10 centimeters, no plummet. And on and up and around, most easily the thumb's going to see 10 over the next 14 days. Easily. Maybe expect that total to rise. Okay, so says Robert, who doesn't agree with weather players. How's the pressure? Oh, you better relieve some of it. Yeah, that's going to be the pressure on the tens on that day. And it's showing it's in the middle of a bubble up that's going to do a spit. Up and over. Up and over she'll go. Or if they let the beam go, it should just suction it right through, equalize that low, and then it would go away. But, you know, that would be like letting Mother Nature itself, rather than a bunch of MFers, you know, with their EMF-MFers. Bunch of MFers. And what else we get to show you today? Oh, it's just good. It's an interesting day for Australian weather. We'll put on your radar first, and we'll go over here right into the north. And the nipple ripple is still blasting up there, the old plate text nursery, and the low data zone going on here. They're not Star Trek fans, they ain't no data. A few white wanderers out here, but nothing really huge. And as we look over here on the corridor in the next couple days, you will see some rains coming along over here in this corridor, but it was nothing like super duper huge, because they saved that for a split fall between Innisfail and just north of Cairns, because I think they already got everything they want in Cairns. And so they just want the suburbs now. Yeah. You need some freedom, man. Well, it just needs to have you out of your house with them in control of building whatever the hell they plan to build. Off-world hotel, who knows what the hell they're going to have. And as we get in toward Wednesday, you'll start to see some of those flows I was talking about coming in. And, well, you are in the tropics, and you can expect this time of year. Let's see, sources, visa. And maybe I can come to Queensland that day, or should I wait? Now, that's going to take time. To fund my trip to come talk with you guys is another whole plan. Let's see if I get my visa first. Somebody was asking me, and I'm going to then welcome that part. So all you trolls out there that think you're going to trash me and stop me from talking, it ain't going to fucking work. Look, I can even do the weather backwards. Whoa. In case you wanted to see that again. Hey, Horks Bay, did you notice something? You got a bit of an up and around move. Hey, so going to be watching for you. Probably get some snows. I think the excess was showing a little bit of totals here coming all the way down through Kaikoura again in a great big rectangle of frozenness. Is the great big frozen pole just for you. Pointed right at Wellington. Hint. Give him the big frozen pole. Yeah, but the accumulations of the rains are a bit of a concern because they already had some snows. But if the accumulation of precipitation is snow, well, then you're okay. But if it melts, it's you're fucked. But the cold temperatures I see coming, I don't see a chance of that melting all down where I'm pointing. You guys got some cold going on, and it's going to stay that way because it could perhaps be a winter time. But it definitely looks like you get some soggy times coming on the 10s, and I guarantee you within 14 days you're going to see every bit of 10 along this coastline, centimeters of rain. Hey, so get ready again for the sagittation of the Whitianga. And well, oh no, it's a Fitianga. Here's that, because that says fuckatawny. I haven't forgot about the fuck word there. Is that W-H-A-K is fuck. And well, if you just say, you know, F-A-W-H-A-K-A, you're calling somebody a fucker. Hey, so watch yourself, all you fuckers over there, fuckatawny. You expect those totals to rise. Because over here, they're swallowing the dreams first. But those totals are coming your way.
Wah. 16 days from now, you'll be arguing over, did he tell us or not?
You know I did. He's gonna know. From the nothings to the somethings. That's your 10-day totals of snow. So really, the only one sees a bunch of snow is up here in this one spot. The very high mountains over here. I'd like to see them from the ground one day. They're beautiful flyovers. Such beautiful trees. blessings to all the forest humane beings out there. Invest the unhumane ones so maybe they will become humane. Kalgoorlie, that's even hard to say. Well, you're at a key junction. Oh, that's a very interesting cropping you've got here. I want to look at that. Okay, Kalgoorlie, expect to make my Imaginarium map. Antarctica, what are we showing here? Lots of big snow bands coming in there, typical for winter time. USA, no smalls. Terrible totals coming up for New England and all that. I'll tell you that. Up through the swat through here in New England. It's all been aimed by the next rad. You can see how I showed you here earlier in the broadcast how they made that corridor for these flows to occur. So with that said and with that done, big love to you all. Eyes, you'll be in the front part of my forecast tomorrow morning. Big love. Oh, wait, one more thing to show. We had a beaming incident going on, cutting the river of moisture over here just outside South America. See it right here? And it came all the way across the United States and also helped set up a corridor that is doing this flow. So I just want to roll this for a minute to capture this data so you can see this. Then they edited it out. But not before I showed it to you. See the beam coming across? And then that one pulses out. So you more than likely have a ship out here. And it's beamed over here. Bzzzt. And away that goes. They have cut the river of moisture. I said they had to cut that loose. There's the big beam to do it. They used an excuse of a solar mass ejection CME today. Go listen back to a few days ago forecast where I said they're going to have to use the excuse of a CME. And you'll see this little beam here come out to the front. It's going to start to direct this a little more to the south. See that right there? So I'm watching. If it comes all the way to the front any more than that, it's going to send us into the southern path. If not, it's going to direct that right in here north, and it's going to take it nearly over the top of Hawaii. Okay, so I have a concern. I'm watching this very, very closely, all right, because there's the beam I've been waiting on. And it's going to increase the earthquake risk over Central America in a huge way, especially Mexico. Okay, so I'll be watching for that right about there. Because that other beam came up, that one went across, and it's a huge pulse. So, right, let's be safe, be you, be free. Be oneness. Big love. Peace.